Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Hello everyone and welcome to your English class. In our lesson today, we will continue with our second unit, which is titled Careers. Our lesson today is the second part of the writing lesson in your books, page 28 and 29. All you need for the lesson today is your books, page 28 and 29, a sheet of paper and a pen to take down your notes. Let's get started. You had a homework yesterday, which was to collect information about a person who you know and make notes about. Find someone who's doing a job that you find it interesting. Then write notes in the about this person's education, they graduated from where, then experience, their job, their work experience, and also this person's skills interested in and good at. Who have you thought about and what job have you thought about? For me, I have thought about someone we have covered already. Education, bachelor degree in architecture, courses in marketing. It was about Michael, who we had the chance to listen to his interview in the listening part, the listening lesson. He had a bachelor degree in architecture and courses in marketing. What about his job experience? 3 years as an architect in an apartment, in apartment building company, and also part-time sales job in college. So part-time, and after graduation, he had 3 years of experience. How about his skills? He is good at communicating with people, and also he's having architectural skills. So skills that are related to the job and dealing with people. You can come up with any person that you feel that they are doing an interesting job and write about their education, qualifications, job experience, and also their skills. What are they good at? What are they interested in? Okay, let's get to our lesson today. By the end of today's lesson, you will be able to take notes on a written text, identify a cover letter, and write a cover letter. Ready? Let's get started with it. As we have mentioned about the idea of a resume is a formal document that a job applicant creates to show his or her qualifications for the position. You will write all the required things. Formal, write the details, your details in there. What information can you add? If you can refer to the reading lesson, you can find them. Information like your details, your information, your email address. You can add information about your phone number and your address. Also, your education, your courses, qualifications, certifications. You can also add information about your experience, job experience. Have you ever worked before you apply for this job? What did you do there? And for how long? Awards and honors. If you have participated in any competition, you won any prizes, just mention it. It will add more to your CV. And your skills, which are, I am good at, I am interested in. Things that you are good at, you are interested in. However, we said, just writing your CV or resume is not always enough. What would you add to make it like your CV or resume is different and the interviewer or the person who's going to hire would love to read your CV? I want to promote yourself. You will add a cover letter. What is it? As a reminder, it's a document that you send with your CV. So with the plus, it's just like the job profile that you will add it to the CV. No, you will add it as an extra paper with your CV. It is specifically written with the job you are applying for in mind, allowing you to highlight certain areas you think you would make you the right for the role. I want to apply for a teacher's job, but I want to tell them something that's not a qualification, not a skill, something that will make them hire me. I am different than the others, and they will add them in this part. Sometimes you are having certain skill that you couldn't add in your CV, you can add it in here. So you are promoting yourself. You are trying to show how good you are for this role or for this position. And we said, what information can you add? The recipient details. Who are the one who would read it, right? The person's position, name, address, all the person's information. Introduction, it's a letter. You have to introduce it. You're not going to just go in and write what you want to say. You have to introduce in a very short sentences. Why you? And this is the core and the most important part of your cover letter. Why you? Why would I choose you, not your colleague or your sister? Why you think that you are the best person for this position? What are the things that will make you different? And by the end, it's a letter you introduced. You have to have a closing. You're going to close it with a thank you note or with like a sincerely best wishes or whatever. So these are the headlines and what information you can add in here. We're having sincerely, skills, attachments, and we're having the address. In the recipient details, what would you add? You will add the address, the one who would receive. I'm sending it to Ahmed Al-Saleh, put his address. Introduction, what would you add in here? In the introduction, you will add attachments, my CV, I am enclosing or attaching my CV, my certifications, my courses. What are you going to add to this letter? Why you part, the most important part, what are you going to add in here? You will add your skills, the things that you believe that you should mention. And also in the closing part, you will write sincerely, best wishes, looking forward to hearing from you. Okay, so these they are. Now we will take them, these part one by one in here. So we said it is the cover letter, which is the document that you will add to your CV. And it is for a purpose. You have to highlight your purpose. Why are you writing this? Is it just like an informal letter? No. Why are you writing? You have to mention the reason, the why you are writing. I am writing this because I am applying for this or that job. And we have to highlight here your audience. Who's going to read this cover letter? Is it a friend, a colleague? No. It is your employer, your to-be employer, your future employer. So the language in here have to be correct language and also formal language. Okay. So let's start with the first one in here, which is the recipient details. And we're going to mention the information that you can add to the recipient details. Ahmed Al-Saleh, it's not you. He is the human resources manager. Who is Ahmed Al-Saleh? Because he's going to receive this one. The one who is going to get it to Ahmed Al-Saleh will check. Ahmed Al-Saleh, the human resources manager. This is the name for the company, 0A Company. And this is his address. The address for Ahmed Al-Saleh at 0A Company. Phone number and email address in case they needed to contact Ahmed Al-Saleh on his email. So the details on the top left corner. Okay, followed by, we will have here the introduction part. In the introduction part, let's read it together. Dear Mr. Al-Saleh, I am writing to apply for the job for the public relation position advertised in PR journal. Notice here, he is telling why I am writing. You are introducing in here. I am writing to tell that I want to apply now. And with relation to your job, which job, this job, you advertised in here. Be very specific. Then, as requested, I am enclosing my job application and whatever. Tell the manager or the one you are contacting, what are you adding in case something was missing? I am adding my CV, I am adding an application, I am adding my courses. You can find maybe 3 to 4, let's say, extra papers. So these they are. Then we will go to the most important part, which is the why you part. In this part, what information would you would add? This is the core for your cover letter. You are adding information about you. I believe that my experience, education, and training will make me a competitive candidate for this position. All the things that I got, I'm an experienced person, I have the good education and my training, and I'm a good person for this position. The key strength that I possess for success in this position. And here is the most important thing. What are my key strengths? The things that will make me a strong candidate, that will make you choose me. And he will highlight them here. I am a dedicated and enthusiastic professional. I am a person who is motivated. I welcome challenge and strive for continued excellence. I like challenge and changing. I am an experienced and effective communicator. I am good at communicating with people. I have had 5 successful years in PR and large corporations with a bachelor degree in public relations and a master degree in intercultural communication. So, and I have experience. So, my experience and my education and my understanding of the factors involved in the successful operation of the multinational organization such as yours. So my courses, my skills, my personality, my education, all of these. I am a good candidate, so I help you improve. I help you develop. I will be a good addition to your company or to that position. So this is the part where you are telling, can you see me? That's me. I am a good person for the position. By the end, are you going to stop in here? We can't stop. We are going to go to the closing part, in which, thank you for your time and consideration. You have to be polite and formal. I look forward to hearing from you. I will be waiting to hear from you. Sincerely, Saud Khalid. Write your name here. Saud Khalid is the candidate's name. He is Saud. Okay? So this is for the cover letter. Now, I wanted to collect information about the person and make notes in the chart. Saud Khalid, that we have read about his qualifications and his skills. I want you to read again, and you will write his qualities, his qualifications, and his experience. I want you to listen to the whole thing, and while you are listening, you are supposed to fill these blanks out. His qualities, qualifications, experience. Let's listen.
Ahmed Al-Saleh, Human Resources Manager, Zeroa Company, 87 Riyadh Road, Jeddah, 555-555-5555. ahmed.alsaleh@email.com. Dear Mr. Al-Saleh, I am writing to apply for the public relations position advertised in PR Journal. As requested, I am enclosing a completed job application, my certification, my resume, and 3 references. I believe that my experience, education, and training will make me a competitive candidate for this position. The key strengths that I possess for success in this position include, I'm a dedicated and enthusiastic professional. I welcome challenge and strive for continued excellence. I'm an experienced and effective communicator. I've had 5 successful years in PR in large corporations. With a bachelor's degree in public relations and a master's degree in intercultural communication, I have a full understanding of the factors involved in the successful operation of a multinational organization such as yours. Thank you for your time and consideration. I look forward to hearing from you. Sincerely, Saud Khalid.
Okay, after reading and listening to the cover letter by Saud Khalid, now you can write about his qualities, qualifications, and his experience. What are the qualities? The qualities in here, he he is having motivation and initiative, flexibility and adaptability, and communication skills. From the why you part, you can find he is motivated, enthusiastic. He is also flexible and adaptable with any change, any challenge. How about qualifications? His education, courses, bachelor degree in public relations, master's degree in intercultural communication. So he's having a bachelor's degree, master's degree. If you can find any courses, you can add them in here. Experience, previous work experience. He's having 5 years in PR in large corporations. So I have worked 5 years before I come and apply for this job position. Okay, now I want you to speak about you, yourself, and write information about yourself in the you column in here, which is the qualities, qualifications, and experience. If you can't find anything about yourself, you can write about someone that we have read about. Maybe someone you know. Let's start with the qualities in here. Qualities, I have communication skills, I have interpersonal skills, I deal with many people, and teamwork skills. How about qualifications? Qualifications and education, degree in media, courses in public speaking. How about experience, previous work experience? A TV show host in 2018. I have brought these from the resume or the CV that we have read about in the reading lesson. So these are the qualities, qualifications, and the experience. Okay, now we're going to go to the writing part. But before we go to the writing, we have to follow certain rules, so we will avoid any mistakes. Before you start writing, you have to mind your own ideas. You have to know what ideas you are going to write. Am I going to write a formal letter, informal letter? Is it a paragraph, two paragraphs? The ideas that I will include, they should be related, not something like different ideas. Also, paragraphs. You have to know how many paragraphs am I going to write. Each one paragraph will include one information, not to mix the information or to say the details and the ideas together. One paragraph, so one idea. Also, grammar. Focus, what tense are you going to use? Present, past, future? You have to know what are you going to speak about. Then, spelling. Mind your spelling and always double check your spelling. One more, capitalization. You can refer to the writing lesson in Unit 1. And check the capitalization after the full stop, at the beginning of the sentence, if it's a name. Always make sure that you capitalize the correct words. And punctuations, which is like a full stop, comma, question mark. These are important so you don't mess up. Let's go ahead. Here, we will start with the recipient details because we are writing about someone. He is Ahmed Al-Saleh, the human resources manager. I will just write this because here we am writing notes, not a paragraph. In the introduction part, I will say, I'm writing to apply for a TV show host position, advertise on your website, and I am enclosing my resume. These are the things that I will add information. Why you part? Here, a TV show host in 2018. I hosted a TV show in 2018. And the closing, you will say, I look forward to hearing from you. Is this a cover letter? Not actually. These are the notes. But from here, you can come up with your cover letter. Start with small information, then you will upgrade it. Okay, so we started with Ahmed Al-Saleh, Human Resources Manager. When I say Ahmed Al-Saleh, Human Resources Manager, here is the recipient details. Is this enough? Not really. This is not enough. You have to upgrade it now from being a note to a paragraph. It could be into 2 to 3 sentences in the correct form, correct capitalization, and other things. Ahmed Al-Saleh, Human Resources Manager, 08 TV channel, 87 Mecca Road in Mecca, his phone number and his email. Notice the capitalization, capital A, and As-Saleh, capital A. Position, the name of the position, capitalization in here. We don't use full stops because here it is not a sentence, it's an address. Okay, the recipient details who this person is, where is he, and how we can contact this person. All done with the first part, which is the recipient details. The following part, which is the introduction part. What do we have in here? I'm writing to apply for the TV show host position advertised on your website. I am enclosing my resume. This is like in bullets. Now I want to put it in a paragraph in a better written way. Dear Mr. As-Saleh, formal writing. Start with Dear Mr. As-Saleh. And you will use Mr. and capital letter for the name. I am writing to apply for the TV show host position advertised in your on your website last week. So we added information as advertised on your website and we have last week. I am enclosing, what are you adding here? My certifications, my resume, and some references. Notice in one paragraph, continuous sentences, full stop here, full stop and capital letter. I'm using a paragraph. Check your spelling, check your grammar. Then it will be followed by the why you here, the important part, the why you paragraph. A TV show host in 2018. This is not enough. I believe that my experience and training will make me a good choice for your show. They're having a show and they need a host. I am a dedicated and a hardworking professional. I welcome change and challenges. I am an experienced and effective communicator. I have had my own show in 2018. So he spoke here about his skills, his work experience, all the things that will make me a person who would be very, very good for this position. So we have changed the note into a whole paragraph. Then the closing in here, I look forward to hearing from you. You can change it too. Thank you for your consideration. Thank you for your time. I look forward to hearing from you. Formal, sincerely, Carr Barthes, which is the resume and on page on the reading lesson, page 26. Okay, and you can put it in the correct order. Start with the address or the recipient details, introduction, and the why you, followed by ended it up with the closing part. Okay, so this is for the cover letter. For your homework, I want you to write your own cover letter. Think about you, yourself. You have had your own CV or your resume. Now it is the time to write your own cover letter. You can write it on your workbooks on page 18. There is enough space for to write that. Just write your own cover letter. Do not forget, write the introduction and the why you part. Advertise yourself in good wording. Okay, I guess that is it for the lesson today, and thank you so much for your time.